Hi, I'm Calandra Davis, part of the Faculty Advisement Team at Pearson. In this video, I'll share with you how you can use the Companion Study Plan in your courses. The Companion Study Plan is a feature that you can enable in your course to give students access to practice problems and quizzes that will help them prepare for a specific quiz or test. Mastery of the Companion Study Plan can also be set to be a prerequisite to the paired quiz or test. Why use the Companion Study Plan? The Companion Study Plan will guide your students to what they need to practice to be successful on an assessment that you've created. It also continually updates with each submission of an assignment that you set to affect study plan mastery, giving your students a true sense of how they're doing with the course content at any given time. This is in contrast to our personalized homework feature, in which a test or quiz can only personalize a homework assignment once. While the general study plan available in your course by default can be customized through the study plan manager to limit chapter, section, objective, and even exercise coverage, the companion study plan gives you the ability to create a focused study plan with just a few clicks. So let's take a look at how you would enable the companion study plan. If you go to your assignment manager, go to the test or quiz that you would like to enable a companion study plan for, or if you haven't created it yet, you can do that at this time. So I'm going to edit my quiz. And to create a companion study plan, all I have to do is check this box to assign a companion study plan to go with that quiz. I'm going to save and assign it. I should also mention that you'll see that this companion study plan will also be set as a prerequisite to this quiz, and we'll talk a bit more about that in a few moments. Once enabled, click on the assignments link so you can see what this looks like from your student's point of view. And you'll now see a study plan listed for this specific quiz. If we click on that, you'll find that this companion study plan is populated only with the objectives available on this particular quiz. So now that you've seen how to enable the companion study plan, let's look at three ways in which the companion study plan is commonly used in math courses. One way that the companion study plan can be used in your class is as a replacement for homework. In math courses, we traditionally have our homework set up at the section level. So in chapter one, there's probably a 1.1 homework assignment, 1.2, etc. Instead, we can use more of a mastery approach and create a pretest that the student would take, and whatever objectives are mastered in that pretest will be reflected in their companion study plan, and we'll create a companion study plan from the post-test for that chapter that we expect the student to show mastery on. So let's take a look at how we would set this up in our MyLab course. In my course, I already have my pretest created. Now I need to create my companion study plan. So I'm going to go to my chapter test, or you can create it if you don't have it done already. And I will enable my companion study plan. I'll go to my settings for the assignment, and I'll see that the companion study plan is a prerequisite for this test, which is what I want because that will be the homework that the students have to work on prior to taking the test. We can see that right now the setting is that students must earn 12 out of 12 mastery points to be able to access my chapter test. A mastery point is just an objective. So this means that there are 12 objectives on my test that are in the study plan. And I can specify how many of these objectives I want the students to master before they can have access to my test. I can also specify which attempt I want this mastery to start at. So since I want students to have to master my study plan before they get into the test, am going to leave this at all attempts. I'm not going to change this value just yet, and you'll see why in a moment. Let's go to the next screen. So there's an additional setting once you have the companion study plan enabled. And on this screen, you can add additional objectives to your study plan. Because we will not have every objective that we want students to practice on a test, or the test would be an unreasonable length, we can add additional objectives at this point that we want students to have to master prior to taking the test without actually adding these questions to the test. So you can expand the section and see the objectives that are available and check every objective that you want students to have to practice as part of their study plan. You can see that the mastery points or the objectives will change based on what you select. And now I have another opportunity to choose the minimum number of mastery points that I want to require. 80% is a best practice that a lot of folks use. So I'm going to want my students to master at least 16 of the 20 objectives in their study plan before they can access the chapter test. And now I will save my settings. If we click on assignments to take a look at this from the student's point of view, the student's workflow would be to start by taking the chapter pretest. That would feed into their study plan. So anything that the student has mastered would be listed in the mastered section that would appear at the bottom of their study plan. So you can see that I have some mastered objectives already. And everything that the student hasn't mastered will be listed for them to practice. At the top of the screen, the student can see how many objectives there are for them to practice, as well as how many they have already earned. They also know how many objectives or mastery points they must earn before they can begin their test. This will help to ensure that the student doesn't feel stuck. They can see very clearly what they've mastered and what they need to master in order to access their assessment. Another way that the companion study plan is used, and my favorite way to use it, is as a prerequisite to getting additional quiz or test attempts. I'm sure that you have seen, as I have, when giving students multiple attempts at a quiz, that there are some students who will go into the quiz, look at all of the questions, not give a good effort on that first attempt. They'll review their notes and learn how to do the types of questions on that quiz, and then come back into the quiz and score really well. And the question lingers whether the student has actually learned the concept or if they just learned how to solve a particular type of question. Requiring the companion study plan as remediation between quiz attempts will be a way to prevent this from happening. The way that we would set up the study plan in this case would be to go to your assignment manager, and I want to require remediation between the attempts for my Chapter 2 review quiz. I'm going to edit that quiz, and I will still check the box to enable the companion study plan. When I get to my settings, I want to change my prerequisites. And instead of having the companion study plan mastery of it required for all of the attempts of the students, I want to give my students a freebie first attempt. Maybe they've diligently worked on the homework assignments, and I want them to have access to that quiz immediately. However, starting with the second attempt, so this means the second attempt and every attempt thereafter, the student will have to master the number of mastery points I specify prior to getting that second attempt at the quiz. So again, targeting 80% is a best practice. So I wanted my students to, let's say, master at least 12 of the 14 objectives in this companion study plan. And I will save that and then save and assign it. So let's take a look to see what this looks like from the student's point of view. When the student goes into their assignment manager, there's no prerequisite for that chapter review quiz. So the students may go in and take that quiz. They may look at the questions, not really try. So I'm just going to submit this quiz. But notice now what happens is that there's a prerequisite flag that's saying that they have to earn at least 12 out of the 14 mastery points before they can gain access to that quiz again. So the student would go into their companion study plan and work through the objectives that they have not mastered. And as I mentioned before, they can see exactly how many objectives they must master before they can get access to that particular assessment. A third way that the companion study plan can be used in your course is as practice for a high stakes exam. So this is somewhat similar to the last example that I gave you, except since you're making the companion study plan practice for this exam, you may want to make it optional. Let's say that we want to enable the companion study plan as optional practice for our Chapter 2 test. I will edit that test, and I'll check the box to enable the companion study plan. And from our prerequisite settings, I want to specify the number of mastery points the students need to access that test, and I would just make that 0 and save it. Make sure that you go to the next screen for your settings, because sometimes you may have to re-enter in the number of minimum mastery points for that particular companion study plan, and then save and assign it. When you do that, if I click on assignments to see the view from a student's point of view, I'll see now that this companion study plan for my Chapter 2 test is available, and I have access to the Chapter 2 test. There is no prerequisite. So often students ask for additional practice for tests. This is a great way and a quick way that you can provide that for your students without much of a time commitment on your part. As you can see, the companion study plan is a powerful tool that's easy to activate in your courses to give students additional practice or required remediation to help them achieve success in your courses. The benefits to instructors is that it's a small time commitment to set up, and we as the instructors have the ability to set the mastery levels that we want students to achieve. We can also be assured that students will not get stuck in the study plan. They're always able to determine where they are and how much more work they need to do to attain mastery.